Hello everyone, Gautam Ayurvedic Academy online classes welcomes you all. In the continuation of detailed drug series, today we are going to see Ardraka or Shunti. Here myself, Dr. M.V.V. Durga Prasad, Department of Dravyaguna, Sharada Ayurvedic Medical College. Here Ardraka is very important drug and it is easily available. And it is best to Vata Kapha Shamaka drug. So because of its qualities, everybody knows and it is easy availability. So commonly it is used in some of the household remedies. Okay, household remedies. So now we will go into the detailed study of Ardraka Shunti. So coming to the Vesha name, Nirukti of the Dravya. Shuntati Hanti Kapham Vatascheti. Mainly it will cure the Vata Kapha Vyadis. And another meaning is Shuntati Shoshayati Kapham Amasyati. Itself it is dried. That's why it dries up the Kapha and Ama. Coming to the synonyms, Nagaram. Nagare prapyam vanidyam apaneshu bahusho labhyate. That means here mainly what he wants to say is ginger is available in markets. It's actually sold in shops. That's why he want to highlight it by saying nagaram. Shrunga veram. Shrungakaro veraha kando asya. So horn shaped rhizomes are seen. That's why it is Shrungavera. Katubadram. Katu beshajeshu badram hitakari. Best katu dravya. Mahaushadam. Mahascha tadaushadam prakrushta karma katrutvat. Very efficacious drug because of its strong action. Vishva Beshajam. Vishvesham Vyadinam Nivarakam. Atava Vishva Prasiddha Beshajam. Commonly used by public because of its qualities and easily availabilities. So these qualities and easy availability, everybody knows it. That's why Vishva Prasiddham Beshajam. That's why it is used by everyone. So it is called Vishva Beshajam. Ushanam. Ushanam means dahakari. Rhizome causes burning sensation. Coming to the regional names, English it is called ginger, Hindi ardrak or sont, Kannada shunti, Marathi chukki and Telugu allamu. Botanical name Gingiber officinale. Here officinale means sold in shops. Are used as a medicine. Family Gingiberaceae, kula Haridra kula, classification of dravya charaka mentioned under triptigna arshogna deepaniya shula prashamana trishna nigrahana stanya shodana. Sushruta mentioned under pippalyadi trikatu bhavaprakasha haritakyadi varga. Coming to the habitat, it is commonly cultivated throughout the sub-Himalayan tracts of UP, Uttar Pradesh, Deccan, Karnataka, Kerala and Bihar, and widely available in Western Ghats. Coming to the morphology, it is a perennial herb with elongated leafy stem and rhizome is horizontal tuberous rootstock. Rhizome is stout and tuberous. Stem is erect, leafy stem, leaves are narrow, subsessile, linear lanceolate. Inflorescence is spike, flowers are greenish with small dark purple or purplish black. So this is the perennial herb. So this is the horizontal rhizome. This is the final rhizome. So this is inflorescence. How inflorescence appear? The flowers will be like this. Coming to the useful part, that is rhizome. And to store a this ginger, there will be a particular process is done for the ginger. Curing of ginger. Ginger is marketed both in the peeled and unpeeled condition. In scrape, the epidermal layer of the rhizome is scraped off with the help of sharp bamboo splinters and then washed in the water and dried in the sunlight 7 to 10 days. Okay? Because it allows the skin to thicken and cut surfaces to heal. That's why it will be dried. So coming to the chemical composition, aromatic oil, starch, fat, fibers, gingerberin, gingerin. Gingerin is a oleoresin, gingerberin is a bit, pungent principle in the ardraka or shunti. Coming to the rasapanchaka, so dried and wet variety, both will be having different. So here everything is same, only guna is different. Katu, ushna, madura, that is ardraka and shunti. Guna is tikshna, rukshna for ardraka. Shunti is lagu, snigdha guna. Okay? Tikshna, rukshna and guru. Shunti is lagu, snigdha. That is the only difference. Coming to the doshagnata, vata, kafahara, karma is pachana, bedana, rochana, deepana, swarya, vibandhahara, shulahara, jwarahara and grahi. Rogagnata, ajirna, agnimandya, amavata, chardi, shula, shwasa, shota, udara and arshas. Coming to the amayaka prayoga, it's very important. Amayaka prayoga is there, that is for agnimandya. It is commonly everybody can follow this. Bhojanagre sadapatyam. So bhojanagre sadapatyam. Before consumption of food, it is patya. It is daily you can take. Lavana ardraka bhakshanam. The piece of ginger with a pinch of salt. Which what it will do? Agni sandipanam hridyam jihva kanta vishodanam. So agni sandipanam, which increases the digestive fire, and also it is good for the heart, that is hridya. Jihva kanta vishodanam, it will cleanses the tongue and throat, oral cavity. Coming to the arshas, especially kaphaja arshas, quata of ginger and kulata is beneficial in kaphaja arshas. Parinamashula, in parinamashula, paste of shunti, tila and guda when consumed with milk is beneficial in parinamashula. Sirashula, that is headache, in head sirashula the nasya is used. Nasya of guda, shunti, kalka is beneficial in sirashula. Here matra, there is a particular matra here. Swarasa is 3 to 10 ml. Churna is 750 mg to 1.5 gram. Particularly it is having contraindications. Fresh ginger is contraindicated in kushta, pandu, mutra krutra, rakta pitta, vrana, jwara, daha and grishmarutu and sharadrutu. Because it is pitta vardaka, because of its tishna guna and ushna virya, because of that it is contraindicated in all types of pittaja vikaras. Especially it is all are pittaja vikaras and pittaja rutus, pitta sanchaya or pitta prakopa rutus are contraindicated. Coming to the important formulation, shunti kashaya, mainly indicated in agnimandya, kasa and shula. Nagaradi churna, grahani dosha, arshas. ಶುಂಠಿ ರಾಸ್ನ ಕಷಾಯ ವಾತಜ ಸ್ವರಭೇದ. ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕಲ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ದ್ರಿಕ ಭೇದನಿ ಗುರುವಿ ತೀಕ್ಷ್ಣೋಷ್ಣ ದೀಪನೀಮತಃ ಕಟುಕ ಮಧುರೋಪಾಕೆ ರೂಕ್ಷ ವಾತಕಫಾಪಃ ಯೋ ಗುಣಾಃ ಕಥಿತಂ ಶುಂಠಿಯ ಸ್ಥೆಯಪಿ ಸಂತ್ಯದ್ ಆರ್ದ್ರಕೆ ಅಖಿಲಂ. ಸೊ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ದ್ರಕ ಅಂಡ್ ಶುಂಠಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಭಾವಪ್ರಕಾಶ ಹರಿತಕ್ಯಾದಿ ವರ್ಗ. ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ದ್ರಕ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.